Company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. which is commanded of Paul to be honorable among all men, therefore is not to be by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God, into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. Who gives this woman to marry this man? Christopher, Jessica, I require and charge you both, as you will answer in the day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you knows any impediment why you may not lawfully be joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be ye well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than as God's word doeth allow, their marriage is not lawful. Christopher. Without have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony, will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live? Jessica. Will you have this man be thy wedded husband to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I, Christopher,
take you, Jessica, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. Thereto, I pledge you my faith. Jessica, repeat after me. I, Jessica, take you, Christopher, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for sick, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, to love, to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge you my faith. With this ring I thee wed, and with all my worldly goods I thee endow. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Jessica, repeat after me. With this ring I thee wed, and with all my worldly goods I thee endow. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
seem to say such dangerous things.
But from the beginning of creation, God made them man and female. For this cause shall a man leave his mother and father and cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. So then they are no more twain, but one flesh.
Let's pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just give you thanks for this day. We thank you, Lord, for Christopher and Jessica. We pray, dear God, that you would anoint them, anoint this marriage. Dear Heavenly Father, just help them, Lord, to keep you at the center of their heart, at the center of their home, Lord. Loving one another and taking care of one another for the rest of their lives, Lord. Putting you first, Lord. And just be with them, Lord, and just give them the strength to hear each and every problem that occurs and just help them, Lord, to just look to you for the guidance in their lives each and every day. In Jesus' sweet name we pray and ask it all. Amen. Having pledged your faith in and love to each other, and having sealed your solemn marital vows by giving and receiving the ring, acting in the authority vested in me by the laws of this state and looking to heaven for divine sanction, I pronounce you husband and wife in the presence of God and this assembly of witnesses. Therefore, let all men take care in the sight of God. This holy covenant shall ever remain sacred. Wherefore God hath therefore what God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. I pronounce you man and wife. Christopher, you kiss your brother. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Fink. Thank you.